Hello, Fright fans. Be sure to subscribe.
And click that bell.
Yes, yes, Freddy, we know. Click the bell, that way you'll always be notified of all the slasher mayhem brewing here in the 80s slasher library.
And click that like button, or I'll make sure you never have pleasant dreams again.
And be sure to follow the 80s slasher librarian on Twitter. Join the Facebook group page and the subreddit. And show your support on Patreon and the merch store. Links in the description below. Join now, or playtime will be over. Tonight's upload is brought to you by the patrons of the 80s Slasher Librarian. That's DK.
Bonanza Jellybean, Brie Girl.
Carl Eakins, Cecilia Spears, Krista Campbell, Allison Saib, Hawaii, Iron Elixir, Jay Gardner, Catherine McClear, Kristen Kay, Lauren Vaught, Liam Anderson,
Michael, Rob Davey, Ryan Woodward, Sean Campbell, William Schaefer,
and Willow Ravenwood. Thank you all for supporting the channel.
We couldn't do it
without you.
He said, "Hi there, ain't I lucky? Pleased to meet you. Call me Chucky. I'll always be your very bestest friend. You know, pals are hard to come by, but you'll find that I'm a good guy who'll stick with you until the very end." Then, much to my surprise, he rolled his head and he blinked his eyes. So I took him home to be my very own. And things were really going swell. Through my auntie slipped and fell. Chucky laughed and said, "Now we're alone.
C-H-U-C-K, why'd you come out and play?
Listen up, fool, I'll tell you why. Chucky's bad, that ain't no lie.
Chucky, Chucky, go away. You're too rough when you play.
Over in the corner, peekaboo. Honey, honey, ha-ha, I see you." Well, things started getting stranger. TV warned of danger, and Chucky said that he was really bugged. 'Cause it isn't very funny being treated like a dummy. So I went and gave that little guy a hug. But he pushed me away and said, "I'm sick of this child's play. No more of a sacred guy from now on." Then I got really scared, 'cause he jumped straight up in the air and laughed and started cursing up a storm.
Child's Play 3, the novelization of the film by Matthew J. Costello. Chapter 28. "I saw them too, kid. It's no good down here now. Get moving." Tyler stood there. He had seen Andy and Da Silva. They were there, his real friends coming to save him. "You losing your hearing, little twerp? I said get moving." Tyler felt the gun, the cold metal twisting against his ribs. "Go up there. Now, run," Chucky said. Tyler held the doll tight and ran away. They were moving closer to the sound of the calliope. Tyler heard the thumping of the drum, jingling bells, the strange wheezing sound of the organ. He saw the carousel, the roof looking like a funny hat strung with red and blue and yellow lights. It was the carousel. "I was on a carousel once," Tyler thought. "My dad took me. And this man put these rings in this arm, and I tried to grab them, but I couldn't. Not until Dad helped me, holding me up away from the horse. It felt great to hook the ring."
"Wait a second," Chucky said. "Wait."
Tyler watched the doll turning to look back.
"Damn it. They're still coming. That goddamn Andy just won't give up. You know what I'm gonna have to do to him, huh, kid? Just what I did to those two stupid cops. I'll have to ventilate old Andy's head."
Chucky turned, looking at the spinning carousel. He nudged Tyler.
"Go up that way."
Tyler ran up the ramp. He whispered in Tyler's ear,
Keep moving, kid. It's called cutting the line. Let me know if you want me to blow any of these rubes away. Tyler pushed his way through the crowd, a small kid nudging past grown-ups. Tyler moved to the front of the line. The operator looked down and saw him. Hey kid, what do you think you're doing? Wait in line. You'll get on the next.
Let's go, Tyler, Chucky hissed. Get on the goddamn carousel. Now.
Tyler ducked under the chain and ran past the operator who yelled at him. The horses sped by and the music thumped loudly.
Get on the goddamn carousel, Chucky yelled.
Tyler chewed his lip. He waited until there was a space between horses and then he jumped onto the spinning platform. The sound of the calliope grew in Andy's ears. The thumping, the jingling sounds, the bellows making the organ pipes hoot.
Where are they?
Da Silva said. Andy pointed straight ahead at the carousel.
There!
He saw Tyler standing right next to the spinning platform, watching a horse go up while the operator ran over to him. A little boy holding a doll. Andy then saw the gun. He thought, the poor kid. And once again, Andy remembered his promise, what he was going to do to Chucky. 1,000,000 goddamn pieces. Da Silva grabbed his arm.
Oh God, Andy, he's gonna jump onto the carousel.
But even as she said the words, Andy watched Tyler jump onto the disc. The movement of the platform made the kid fall and roll forward. The crowd gasped, watching the strange scene. Still holding the doll, Tyler rolled forward and hit his head against the upraised hoof of one of the horses.
We have to get him,
Andy explained, moving again, pushing through the line of people. Da Silva followed him as he made his way to the carousel, to Tyler, to Chucky.
Get up, Squirt. Get your little black ass up.
Tyler nodded. Tyler's head hurt where he had banged it, on the merry-go-round horse. The operator was still yelling at him.
Hey kid, stay down! Just stay down now!
He doesn't see Chucky, Tyler thought. Doesn't see that Chucky's holding a gun up to me.
Tyler felt the merry-go-round slow, and then Chucky kicked him.
I said get the hell up and get ready to jump off at the back.
As the disc slowed, Tyler stood up and got ready to jump off. He saw Barkley and then just behind him, Da Silva.
They're coming for me, he thought. They're coming to rescue me.
Get ready, Chucky hissed in his ear. Ready, ready.
The carousel slowed down even more and Tyler faced the back of the carousel building, which was an empty lot. There was tall grass here and empty cans. Far away, another ride glowed in the night, fiery red.
Now! Chucky yelled. Now, goddammit!
And Tyler jumped off. Tyler landed on concrete. A small fence cut him off from the lot.
Over you go, Tyler. Just make sure that you don't drop the Chuck Man.
Tyler climbed over the fence, clutching the horrible doll close, crying again. Because he just kept getting more and more scared. Andy jumped onto the slowing carousel, followed by Da Silva. The operator looked up and started yelling.
Hey, what are you two doing? What the hell are you?
Da Silva turned to Andy, the lights spinning, the operator there, then gone, then there. The music slowing.
I don't see them, Andy. They're gone.
Andy nodded. Then as they spun to the back, Andy saw someone moving through the empty lot behind the carousel. But he was spun away before he could get a good look. He grabbed Da Silva's arm.
I think I saw them. Get ready. We're going to have to jump off.
Andy waited until he was once again facing the lot and then he leaped off the carousel. He landed hard, his knees smacking against the concrete walkway around the ride. Da Silva, after a more adroit landing, helped him up.
He looked up at her. Thanks. But when Andy got to his feet, she said, Are you sure that you saw them? Da Silva looked out at the lot. I don't see a thing. As soon as they were out of the tall grass and on concrete again, Chucky leaned close to Tyler's ear and said, Go right, you little shit. Move it. Tyler turned and ran. He saw red glowing lights, but Chucky was guiding him away from the lights, down an alley to the side. Tyler half walked, half ran, stumbling along, moving when Chucky told him to move, stopping when he told him to stop, like now. Okay. Stop here. They were next to a big red metal door. There was a sign on it that said employees only. Let's see if it's our lucky day, Chucky said. Tyler didn't move. That means try the door, buddy boy. Tyler reached out and tugged at the heavy metal door. It wouldn't budge. Pull a bit harder. Tyler pulled back with all of his weight. The door opened with a horrible groaning sound. There you are. I guess we are lucky. Tyler heard screams inside. It must be a ride of some kind. It had been hard to see running here. He was crying so much. Well, what are you waiting for? Get your goddamn ass inside. Chucky jabbed him with the gun, and Tyler thought, I'll go in here, and Andy and Da Silva will never find me. This will be it. Tyler hesitated a second. Chucky jabbed him again. Goddamn, move it. And Tyler walked inside, into the darkness, wondering why people were screaming. No, they can't have disappeared, Andy said. He quickly clambered over the fence and started running through the grass. He heard Da Silva right behind him. As he ran, he checked the dark grass in case Tyler had fallen or was hiding. Then Da Silva yelled at him, Andy, look over there! Andy stopped and looked in the direction Da Silva pointed. A red glow filled the misty air around the ride. Andy read the letters of the ride, Devil's Lair. A leering Satan looked out at them, his eyes rolling back and forth. Skeletons and ghouls danced on the facade of the building. A creepy organ song was playing. Colorful cars were lined up for a ride into the lair. I don't see. There, Da Silva said. Down the alley, the side entrance. Andy saw an alley that ran down one side of the Devil's Lair. But so what? Then he saw the side door shutting. Good eyes, Kristen. They both tore off toward the side entrance to the Devil's Lair. Meanwhile, inside, it sounded like a roller coaster, only it was inside. It was an indoor ride. Tyler heard the clattering of cars rolling through the building, climbing up ramps. He heard the creepy organ music. There were sirens that screamed out, and then the screams of people in the cars and the banging of doors all around them. Tyler couldn't see anything. Just a thin slit of greenish light straight ahead behind doors. There, kid. Move toward the light, bozo. This place is damn near perfect. Tyler took a step and then stumbled on the metal track used by the cars. He fell to the floor. Chucky nearly slipped out of his arms. Be careful with the goods, bro. You nearly dropped me there, clumsy. Now up. Get a move on. Tyler got to his feet and ran to the door. He pushed it open. The sick green light fell on his face, and he saw a cemetery. Tyler looked at the cemetery filled with tombstones, some cracked, a few lying on the ground. Perfecto, Chucky said. That one'll do right over there. It's perfect. Chucky pointed to a tombstone lying on the ground. Tyler carried the doll there. Now put me down. Tyler lowered Chucky to the tombstone. Okay, now it's time to play. But then the boy heard a rattling behind him. A white light flashed,
There was a siren and screaming. A car full of people burst into the scene. The graveyard suddenly came to life. A skeleton flew out of an open hole. A ghost dropped down from the roof. Hands started growing out of the ground.
No! No! No!
Tyler screamed. The people in the car saw him, watched him, but continued to laugh.
They think I'm just like the other tricks, just a machine.
He looked at the people in the car screaming and laughing as the car wove its way through the cemetery. A bat on wires swooped down, filling the room with its horrible squeaks. A rotten corpse stumbled from the back.
Now that's my kind of people.
Chucky laughed. Tyler shook his head. On the other side, he saw a stone house for dead people. The door opened. Something glowed inside. A gigantic moan filled the cemetery. Tyler bit his lip. He tasted blood. He stepped backward and stumbled, falling and rolling. He felt the cold metal of the track. When he looked up, the car was coming right toward him, as the people screamed even louder.
A most excellent place, thought Chucky. Why, there isn't a better place to perform the final ritual and terminate this little fucker.
Chucky saw a skeleton trying to pull itself out of a rotten coffin.
Keep plugging away, babe, he thought.
Tyler was crying and screaming, and then the kid slipped away. Chucky turned.
Hey!
He said, but the kid had fallen onto the track. Hell, Chucky thought. The stupid kid's trying to turn himself into hamburger. The car's gonna plow right into him. Chucky stood up.
All this work to get somebody, and now he's gonna kill himself.
A brilliant light flashed, a giant blinding strobe. Chucky blinked, and when he opened his eyes, the car rumbled out of the cemetery. Chucky looked at the track. There was no one there. Tyler should have been there, squashed, but he wasn't. Chucky hopped off his tombstone.
The brat is still here, inside a pretend grave, maybe hiding behind a cardboard tombstone. Still here. I keep letting myself get distracted, Chucky thought. I keep letting this shit happen. No more screwing around, he thought. The gloves are off. The kid's still here, and he's dead meat. He's mine.
Andy tugged on the side door and it opened. Da Silva grabbed his shoulder and they entered the house of screams together.
I can't see a thing, Da Silva said.
Andy nodded and then, realizing that Da Silva couldn't see him, he said, yes. But as his eyes adjusted to the dark, he saw a thin sliver of grayish-green light ahead. Somewhere behind them, a car rattled.
There's some light, he said.
Holding Da Silva's hand tightly, he walked toward the greenish slit, toward the door. Tyler looked around the tombstone. The car had nearly smashed into him. He just had time to leap away, rolling behind the stone. In the back, the tombstone was just plain wood, not even painted. He peered around the edge, looking for Chucky. The skeletons, the ghosts, the bats were all quiet, waiting for the next car.
I don't see him, Tyler thought. Maybe he left. Maybe he went someplace else, to some other scary room in here.
Tyler looked behind him. The little stone house was just behind him. He heard the terrible rattle of one of those cars riding the metal rail coming closer. Then, with a tremendous kick, the doors flew open. Tyler yelped, startled. Again, the graveyard came to life. He saw skeletons rising from the ground and ghouly guys crawling around. Then, just by his feet, a skeleton grabbed his ankle. Its bony fingers seemed to close and lock on Tyler's ankle. Tyler scrambled away, scurrying like a crab, right into Chucky.
Hey, kid, long time no see, the doll said.
Chucky pointed his gun right at Tyler's head. Tyler backed away, tripping on the skeletons, feeling its rubber body beneath him writhing.
God damn it, kid, get back over here now, Chucky yelled.
Tyler looked around. The door to the stone house was open. Tyler crawled as fast as he could into the stone house. into, he read the word as he rolled inside, into the crypt. The car rattled out of the graveyard, kicking open doors, leaving the cemetery. The door to the crypt slammed shut. Tyler was safe. But, he felt someone, something watching him. Tyler was breathing hard. He heard himself breathing in and out, the sound so loud inside this small room. He felt it behind him. And so, still panting, still sucking in air as fast as he could, but now smelling this place, this small enclosed room, this crypt, he turned around, and he saw a skeleton grinning at him, and glowing just like one of those watches that glow in the dark, grinning at Tyler. The boy watched it, thinking, he knows that there'll be another car, the door will open, and Chucky will be there waiting. Andy pushed open the door.
God, Da Silva said, it's a cemetery, creepy.
Yeah, but perfect for Chucky. Andy looked around. He saw tombstones and some slumped over skeletons. Lots of gray, green, and black, but no orange and red and blue. Andy shook his head.
I don't see him.
Da Silva took a step into the cemetery. She called out,
Tyler! Tyler, are you here?
Andy then yelled,
Tyler! Are you here? Talk!
He heard something, a muffled voice coming from. Andy saw the crypt shut tight. Then again, then the muffled voice.
I'm in here!
Andy ran over to the crypt with Da Silva. He banged on the side of the crypt. Tyler! Tyler, is that you?
Yes, I'm in here, and...
Hang on, Tyler, Andy said. Andy started feeling the outside of the crypt, looking for a way in. He felt the wood seams digging his fingernails in. He moved to the back. Just hang on, Tyler! Andy looked at Da Silva, who was also looking for a door or latch. Some way into the pretend crypt. She looked up at him and shrugged.
We're coming, Tyler! Just...
Tyler looked at the glowing skeleton.
It's just sitting there, Tyler thought. Sitting there watching me. It's not real, he told himself. Not a real skeleton. Just something somebody made.
He heard Andy pounding on the outside of the crypt, feeling the sides. Tyler looked at the skeleton. He reached out a hand to touch it, wanting to feel it for some reason. He chewed his lip more.
It's not real, he told himself.
Close, almost touching those bony fingers that glowed in the dark. Closer. And then, from behind the skeleton, another hand reached out. Chucky's hand.
Hidey-ho, kiddo. Surprise.
Chucky's plastic fingers locked on Tyler's hand. They were so strong. Tyler yelled and squirmed. He heard Andy calling to him. Chucky had been here the whole time. Then Tyler heard the rattling noise, the crazy clackety-clack of another car roaring through the cemetery. The door to the crypt popped open, and the glowing skeleton moved, pushing Chucky. He let Tyler's hand slip away.
They can't save me, Tyler thought. Barkley and Da Silva can't do anything.
The boy ran out and across the tracks just as the car was about to come. Chucky saw Tyler. He saw the car. There might not be enough time, he thought. The car might catch me, slam right into me. And I know how my body is starting to feel. It's like skin now, like flesh. It would hurt bad if that car rammed into me. Chucky shook his head and then darted out, taking as big a steps as his little legs would allow. Bigger, bigger. He heard the screams, the squealing of the metal wheels on the track. Shit, I'm not gonna make it, he thought. But right there on the track, he leaped, and he felt a breeze dust his little doll butt. Way to go, he thought. Good guys always finish first. Tyler was running at an opening in the back of the cemetery scene. Barkley and Da Silva were cut off by the car. Suckers, thought Chucky, as he ran after Tyler. Andy didn't notice that the crypt had opened until the haunted house car was right there, squealing in their ears. He saw a teenage girl break away from a kiss and look over at them, stupidly grinning. When the car passed, he saw Tyler on the other side, crawling through an opening.
and Chucky was just behind him. "Tyler!" he yelled. They disappeared. The car roared past. Andy grabbed De Silva and pulled her to the other side, past the tombstone, to the next room. Okay, Slashaholics, this has been Chapter 28 of Child's Play 3, The Novelization by Matthew J. Costello. This is it, guys. This is the penultimate upload. Only one upload left, which is the conclusion of this great book. Gotta say, I really enjoyed the differences in the book over the movie. I went ahead and put this chapter out by itself because it was a pretty long chapter, and the last upload will probably be about a 40-minute fare. I gotta say, getting into Tyler's head is just so terrifying, and I feel so bad for this kid. A lot worse in the book than I feel worse for him in the book than I did in the movie. You know, and Chucky is more sinister and evil in this book than I've ever seen him in a book or a movie so far. So that's a plus. You know, Chucky's actually a bit scary here. And, you know, not going straight for that one ride makes Tyler's adventure here a lot more terrifying and suspenseful, because you don't know what's going to happen. Chucky's taking him all over the place, and he's not just scared of Chucky. Now he's a 7-year-old kid in this haunted roller coaster ride, and it's scaring the shit out of him. So yeah, I just feel so bad for Tyler here, and Andy is doing everything he can to save him. And man, it seems like it's going to be such a harder job for Andy to put a stop to this than it was in the movie. In the movie, everything just kind of happened exactly the way Andy needed it to. He didn't have to go far. He didn't have to chase Chucky that far, you know. And now anything could be going on. You know, Andy was right there, thought he was going to save Tyler, but Chucky was in that crypt with Tyler, even more terrifying for the boy. And a split second later, you know, Tyler's out and away from Andy. But Chucky's right there after him. You know, it's kind of cool getting into Chucky's head. Him wondering if he's going to make that jump or not. That was pretty neat. I will say, I tried to add, like, roller coaster sound effects, screaming sound effects, and all that. But it really just overpowered the narration. So instead, I just opted for creepy carnival music for the carousel part, like I did for the fairgrounds last upload. And then I opted for the spooky organ music. It's a famous one. I cannot say the name of it. It's like Toccata and Fugue. It's like the most popular, like, creepy organ music ever. And that's what you always hear in these rides, like these creepy carnival, either funhouse things that are spooky that you walk through, or the roller coaster ones that you ride through. So I thought that was the best way to put you guys as listeners into the story with the characters, is to have you hear the type of music that they were most likely hearing, being in this haunted roller coaster. I'm sorry that I didn't add, like, people screaming and roller coaster sounds, but it was just way too much when I tried, and even turning the volume way down on it, it was just drowning out the narration, and to make it work, you wouldn't even hardly be able to hear it anyways. So I hope that the music sufficed. I really felt like it put us there, you know, because that's the type of music you would hear in there. But as far as the differences go from the movie, I really enjoyed Chucky making Tyler jump up on that carousel. Like, I was just expecting that to go wrong. And then whenever he jumped off the back of it, and Andy and De Silva following him, I feel like this, the final part of this climax, spoiler alert, if you haven't seen Child's Play 3, quit listening in 3, 2, 1, 0. I feel like the climax is setting up to be just like the movie. I hope I'm wrong. I'm kind of hoping that the script had a little bit of a different ending than the movie ended up having. And I'm hoping that that comes through in the book, that we get a little bit of it. Just a slightly different ending would be cool, because of all the differences we've had so far that have made this book so much better than the movie, in my opinion. And I love Child's Play 3. You know, a lot of people don't really care for that one because it was rushed, but I like the story. It was an original
story for its time, like the setting and everything, the military school. Having an older version of Andy made it really interesting for him going back up against Chucky, having a new kid for Chucky to go after. And I've really, really enjoyed the novelization of Child's Play 3 so far. And the differences have just blown me away because it's made the story so much better. And I hope you guys are enjoying it too. Let me know in the comment section what you thought of tonight's chapter, if you're excited for the conclusion, and what you thought of this book so far. You know, what are your expectations going into the climax, the final upload of this book? And I'll see you soon with that final upload. And remember, if you would like a shout-out here in the outros on these uploads, just let me know in the comment section. I can say hi to you. I can say hi to someone else from you. I can do a happy birthday, happy anniversary, whatever, you know. This is just us chilling and talking here at the end of these uploads. So if you want a shout-out, just let me know. And until next time, this has been your friendly neighborhood 80 Slasher Librarian saying, thanks for listening.
Pleasant dreams.
And I'll see you real soon.